Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. We're going to start off this afternoon with a little bit of nostalgia. Now, this has popped up in my feed several times. I'm a massive fan of The Inbetweeners. Watched so many people react to it, watched it so many times on the telly myself. And this is, again, from Mojo UK. Top 10 cringy moments from The Inbetweeners. So I'm interested to see which ones they use. Always hilarious, doesn't matter how many times you watch it. Let's crack into it. Okay, here we go.
Oh no, he didn't, did he? Welcome to Watch Mojo UK, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 cringeworthy moments from The Inbetweeners.
Okay.
Every time I don't want one, it's there, and yet the one time I actually need it, nothing!
Before we begin, if you enjoy this video, please subscribe for more great content. These are the awkward, eyebrow-raising, traumatizing scenes from the franchise that made our skin crawl and reflect on the sheer calamity of adolescence and all of the unreliable friends that go with it.
Oh, Christ.
Number 10, Simon tries to talk dirty.
You do want to make love to me, don't you?
Yeah.
Come on, we've all done it at some point. This little snippet of teenage courting reminds us all just how awkward it can be in the early stages of relationship.
Horrible.
After Simon's girlfriend Tara tells him she likes imagining
they're
things
together,
to
now,
get her
aren't
in
they,
the
those
mood
two.
For the old you-know-what, he takes it upon himself to woo her. What starts out as playful foreplay, with mentions of boobs and whatnot, soon spirals into what we can only describe as, well, a threat of football hooligan-esque proportions.
I'm gonna fanny off, you twat!
Okay.
Number 9, the poo shoot.
Sorry, that's my irritating bowels.
Next to up.
Oh, I know, it's from the film.
Water parks. What could be better except for two water parks, obviously? But of course, it's never always fun and games with this lot. In the second Inbetweeners movie, the four lads are in Australia and, as always, trying to impress the ladies.
Yeah, I've not seen the Australia as many
times. One scenario sees them racing down a water slide. Unfortunately, Neil has irritable bowel syndrome and is stood at the top of the slide.
But it's my bowels, they're disabled!
Oh no.
You can see it coming. In a moment of weakness, Neil accidentally sends a tear torpedoing after Will, who watches over his shoulder in terror.
Oh, it's nasty. Oh, it's so high realistic,
Will,
isn't it?
Cue the sequence from Jaws.
Yeah, you are! Yeah!
No!
Number 8, Will plays the guitar.
Sure you got this?
Yeah, I think so.
There's quite a lot of people, so yeah, I can handle it.
Another entry from the same film next, which proves that Will really can kill the cool of anything.
Yeah, maybe twice, maybe three times
Sitting
I've seen that.
Sitting around a campfire and hoping
film.
To impress Katie, Will attempts to change the mood by singing a song. A slow, emotional song originally
really
sung by a woman, in fact, yeah. Roberta Flack. And Will isn't the type of person to hold out on the high notes either. On the contrary.
That is, that's what it is.
The first time ever I saw
what is he doing?
As if it could get any weirder, someone starts to rhythmically dance around the fire before taking off their top. Like an intoxicating lava lamp, you know you want to look away, but you just can't.
Like an eclipse.
Your face.
Number 7, dance floor extravaganza.
Yes, that's one of the best ones.
Them.
That's
Might
not cringeworthy though, that's just classic.
Really?
Dance floors. Either your worst enemy or a platform for brilliance. We'll let you decide which one applies
that's
here.
That's just brilliant. I'm not, that's, there's no cringe in that. That's
Neil,
just
Will
quality.
And Simon jiving across the floor of a club to a table full of girls. In all fairness to the orange-faced Neil, he's throwing some pretty cool shapes.
Hilarious.
But as a collective, with Will bullet-dodging side to side and Simon marathoning on the spot, it's an absolute disaster.
Am I doing it right? Am I in time? Maybe a bit out, but not so you notice.
Jay, on the other hand, like us, watches in utter disbelief from afar. At least they synchronise at the end, sort of.
Sorry, do you mind if I come and talk to you? Because you look nice, and frankly, that's just humiliating for everyone involved.
Yeah, I'm not having that as a cringy moment. That's just, that's hilarious. That's pure comedy gold. That is, that's not cringy for me.
6, Jay buys an ice cream.
I bet her body's still pretty fit.
Yeah, that's pretty, this one's pretty bad.
The field trip to Swanage is legendary in the Inbetweeners series for many different reasons. The one that tops the awkward allotment of agony for Jay, though, is when he goes to buy an ice cream. in search of the legendary Swanage MILF, who apparently has sex with pupils on school trips, Jay starts getting a little frustrated and decides to hedge his bets by confronting an old woman at an ice cream stand. After some small talk, Jay comes out and asks her to, well, obviously she isn't the one he thinks she is, so all Jay gets in return is a confused look from an elderly woman.
Are you the woman who sucks schoolboys off?
Sorry?
Can you suck me off?
Hey, at least he comes away with a cornetto. Number 5, Will goes rogue with a frisbee.
Yeah, that one's,
you
quite,
lot
this
so
one's
gay.
Quite bad
Why
as well.
Why aren't we playing football?
A frisbee in the park? What could possibly go wrong? Well, as always, the guys find a way to try and impress some girls, and what is intended to be a harmless game of catch turns into Will apologising for hitting a woman in a wheelchair with some frisbee.
Oh my god, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Will has a history of picking on disabled people, we all know from his trip to Thorpe Park, but this incident takes things a step further. After apologising profusely, Will then attempts to retrieve his frisbee, which doesn't end well. At least he kept the receipt, not like it matters.
Just child.
Hey, it's my frisbee! I've got a receipt!
Frisbee error.
Number 4, Simon and Will's awkward goodbye.
Feisty one you are!
Being trapped in a love triangle can be a nightmare, especially when it's with one of your best friends. The story goes that Will
fancies
Lauren,
one, that was quite
but Lauren
bad as
doesn't
well.
Fancy Will, she fancies Simon.
Good night then, Will.
Oh, no. I think this one gets less cringy the more you watch it. It becomes funnier the more you see it. The more often you see it, I think this one becomes funnier rather than cringy.
That's okay. I'll wait for Si. You can say anything you want in front of me. We're mates.
So when Simon is saying goodnight to Lauren and Will can't take a hint, we have to watch the two hug as Will
Come
observes
on, Simon.
Some sort of creepy
Come on, Simon.
Weirdo. The hug seems to go on forever, as does Will's constant nagging for Simon to call it a night. Seriously, mate, give it a rest.
Si! Come on now, mate!
Number 3, Jay goes snorkeling.
Do you promise this will be properly filthy, yeah?
Oh yes, like bomb explode from in penis so sexy like
Jay's prone to a few awkward masturbation encounters, but nothing quite hits the highs or sheer creativity of this snorkeling endeavour.
He's got a
sat
few
on his
in there,
bed
surely.
Naked, laptop open, box of ham at the ready, and wearing snorkeling gear. Classic Jay. What's the worst thing that could happen? What about your mum and little sister walking in on you? That's pretty
There's
bad.
Neil
right?
not with
and
him
to
as
make
well?
Matters worse, Jay's mum has something pretty daunting to tell him. You'll never hear "Tell me you love me" the same way again.
Oh, look,
can you come downstairs, please? Your grandfather's died.
Number 2, Simon goes balls
out.
Are
you alright? Yeah, please don't distract me.
Again.
Some people will do anything to cozy up to a girl they fancy, including sporting Speedos and being paraded
horrific.
Along a catwalk like a dog. A little too focused on impressing
Carly and not
getting a boner,
I don't know whether that's cringe or just
boner,
horrific.
Simon morphs into character and heads out. Unfortunately,
and
with a
funny
rather
as
serious
well.
Wardrobe
that's
oversight.
Just so funny.
Balls out, face scrunched into an aggressive scowl and thrusting away. Simon, totally unaware of his flushing, confidently owns the show as a wave of gasps bellow throughout.
Oh, man.
He intends on impressing Carly, but
my
the
jaw
whole
is,
thing
my
backfires.
Cheeks are aching.
You ruined my big night. I thought you liked me, you arsehole.
Hey, Carly, it's all right, it's cool. Come on, Carly, listen, please.
Before we unveil our top pick, here's a few honourable mentions.
Right, what sort of thing
are you doing? Yeah, that's just hilarious as well, that one is.
Some beef-eater gin.
Okay.
So well, no, I've not made of money.
About 2 bottles.
Excellent.
Do you want some wine?
Christ, no.
I'm not made of money. Some wine.
I'll have some extra strong mints for those who are drink driving.
Right, funny boy. Make me laugh.
This is horrifically cringy. I was surprised that one wasn't in it. Oh, horrible. It's just horrible. I can imagine that. I've been at these house parties at that age. Yeah, why is that not in it?
Oh, no.
The dancing gets in it above Phil. That one.
Oh, Jesus.
Phil.
I thought it was a fart, sir. I thought it was a fart.
Number 1, Will and Charlotte have sex.
Oh, that's the one I was thinking of. Him just grinding away on top of it.
We are going to have sex.
Yes, I can.
That one should have been in there.
Of all the people in this eclectic group of misfits, Will is probably the last one you'd expect to actually sleep with someone.
Just not doing
But after a series of baffling events, Will bags himself a girlfriend in Charlotte.
To arms by his side, look.
And starts to put on the moves. He even flat out asks Charlotte if they're going to have sex, to which she replies yes.
It's the arms,
but it's not
sorry,
her unwillingness that's the problem. It's Will's grinding.
Don't move your whole body, just kind of move your hips, you know?
Yeah, that's horrific, that is.
Yeah, you know?
Just my hips?
Yeah.
For a few moments, we are unfortunately treated to an aerial view of Will grinding on her as she laughs beneath. The best part? Will asks her for confirmation on whether or not he just lost his virginity.
Ugh, I'm gonna count it, says I'm
sure. Not gonna count that one.
Can I count it though?
Probably not, no.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, just a little cheeky extra. I know you've probably all seen them as many times as I have as well. But what do you think? Definitely some in there that I think maybe not so cringy, just hilarious, or have moved past that sort of cringy stage of first watching them the first or the second time or the third time I've seen it when you've watched it on the TV or wherever you've watched it. And it's just now become hilarious, actually. Like the dancing, that's just funny. A few others in there that were just funny as well. But definitely him trying to have sex with Charlotte, that should have been in there. Definitely him shitting himself in the exam, that should have been in there. I'm surprised there was nothing from the caravan trip down to Jay's caravan club. There's a few cringy moments in that episode, I'm sure I remember that, but really enjoyed that. Just a little cheeky extra, as I said. I'll do a few others like that as well as we go over the piece. So make sure you hit the subscribe, hit the like, and I'll see you back for some more videos.